COVID-19 vaccination campaigns are happening across the globe, and it is one of the most discussed topics nowadays. We know vaccines are a critical tool in the battle against COVID-19. Scientists from across the globe are collaborating and innovating new vaccines, hopefully that will collectively save lives and end this COVID-19 pandemic. So today we are going to discuss about this vaccination process, how does it work, different COVID-19 vaccines available right now, whether it is safe, any side effects are there. We will discuss all this in today's episode. Before moving further, if you are watching Biomedical Vlogs for the first time, please do subscribe the channel and enable the bell icon to get notifications as well. So what is vaccination? Vaccination is a simple, safe and effective way of protecting people against harmful diseases before they come into contact with them. It uses your body's natural defenses to build resistance to specific infections and make your immune system stronger. Vaccines train your immune system to create antibodies, just as it does when it is exposed to a disease. However, because vaccines contain only killed or weakened form of germs like viruses or bacteria, they do not cause the disease or put you at risk of its complications. How does it work? Vaccine reduce risk of getting a disease by working with your body's natural defenses to build protection. When you get a vaccine, your immune system responds. It recognizes the invading germ such as the virus or bacteria. It produces antibodies. Those are proteins produced by naturally by the immune system to fight the disease, and remembers the disease and how to fight it. If you are then exposed to the germ in the future, your immune system can quickly destroy it before you become unwell. The vaccine is therefore a safe and clever way to produce an immune response in the body without causing illness. We typically remain protected against a disease for years, decades or even lifetime. This is what makes vaccine so effective. Rather than treating a disease after it occurs, vaccines prevent us in the first instance from getting sick. Let's see what are the different types of vaccines available. There are three approaches to designing a vaccine. Their difference lies in whether they use a whole virus or just a part of the germ that triggers the immune system, or just the genetical material that provides the instruction for making specific proteins and not the whole virus. The first one is the whole microbe approach. It is of three types. The first one is inactivated vaccine. The first way to make a vaccine is to take the disease carrying virus or bacterium, or one very similar to it, and inactivate or kill it using chemicals, heat or radiation. This approach uses technology that has been proven to work in people. This is the way the flu and polio vaccines are made. And vaccines can be manufactured on a reasonable scale. However, it requires special laboratory facilities to grow the virus or bacterium safely and can have a relatively long production time. The second type is live attenuated vaccine. A live attenuated vaccine uses a living but weakened version of the virus or one that is very similar. The measles, rubella vaccine and the chickenpox vaccines are examples of this type of vaccine. These approaches use similar technology to the inactivated vaccine and can be manufactured at scale. However, vaccines like this may not be suitable for people with compromised immune system. The third type is viral vector vaccine. This type of vaccine uses a safe virus to deliver specific subparts called proteins. It can trigger an immune response without causing disease. To do this, the instructions for making particular parts of the pathogen of interest are inserted into a safe virus. The safe virus then serves as a platform of vector to deliver the protein into the body. The protein triggers the immune response. The Ebola vaccine is a viral vector vaccine, and this type can be developed rapidly. The second approach is the subunit approach. A subunit vaccine is one that only uses the very specific part of a virus or bacterium that the immune system needs to recognize. It doesn't contain the whole microbe or use a safe virus as a vector. The subunits may be proteins or sugars. Most of the vaccines on the childhood schedule are subunit vaccines, protecting people from diseases such as tetanus, diphtheria, etc. The third one is the genetic approach or nucleic acid vaccine. Unlike vaccine approaches that use either a weakened or dead world microbe or part of one, a nucleic acid vaccine just uses a section of genetic material that provides the instruction for specific proteins, not the world microbe. DNA and RNA are the instructions our cell uses to make proteins. In our cells, DNA is first turned into messenger RNA, which is then used as the blueprint to make specific proteins. A nucleic acid vaccine delivers a specific set of instructions to our cells, either as DNA or mRNA, for them to make the specific protein that we want our immune system to recognize and respond to it. Now we will see what are the different COVID-19 vaccines available right now. The first one is Covaxin, manufactured by Hyderabad-based Bharat Biotech in collaboration with the Indian Council of Medical Research, ICMR. Covaxin is an inactivated vaccine, which means that it is made up of killed coronavirus, making it safe to be injected into the body. Bharat Biotech used a sample of the coronavirus isolated by India's National Institute of Virology. When administered, immunocells can still recognize the dead virus, prompting the immune system to make antibodies against the pandemic virus. The second one is Covishield. Covishield is originally developed by Oxford University AstraZeneca. It has been produced and marketed as Covishield by Pune-based vaccine conglomerate Serum Institute of India. The vaccine is made from a weakened version of a common cold virus known as adenovirus from chimpanzees. It has been modified to look more like coronavirus, although it can't cause illness. When the vaccine is injected into a patient, it prompts the immune system to start making antibodies and primes it to attack any coronavirus infection. Then we have Pfizer and Moderna vaccines. Both are mRNA vaccines, which is a relatively new technology. Essentially, they introduce genetic instruction to your body cells on how to make the spike protein that give the coronavirus its unique shape. Once those spike proteins are created, your immune system reacts to them and learns how to prevent future spike proteins. When the immune system sees the spike protein, it recognizes it as intruder and begins building antibodies against it. The immune system then stores these antibodies, which can fight the real virus as well. Then we have Janssen vaccine by Johnson & Johnson. It uses a different approach to instruct human cells to make the SARS-2 spike protein, which then triggers an immune response. It is what known as a viral vector vaccine. Once the adenovirus enters the cells, they use that code to make spike proteins. J&J employed this same approach to make an Ebola vaccine that has been authorized for use by European Medicines Agency. Then we have Chinese vaccines, Sinovac and Sinopharm. China has been developing COVID-19 vaccines since the very beginning of the pandemic. It was the first country in the world to give a vaccine to some of its population in summer 2020. It currently has 16 different vaccines at various stages of development, but the current frontrunners are from Sinovac and Sinopharm. One of the most searched queries regarding COVID-19 vaccines are, is there any side effects from COVID-19 vaccines? Like any medicine, vaccines can cause mild side effects such as low-grade fever or pain or redness at the injection site. Mild reactions go away within few days on their own. Severe or long-lasting side effects are extremely rare. Vaccines are continuously monitored for safety to detect rare adverse events. Thank you for watching the video. Please do let us know your valuable feedback and suggestions in the comment section below. Thank you. Bye.